China are up to something, all right, and it's not only the South China Sea that is being assimilated by them. They are also looking for extraterrestrial intelligence in space, raising the question, what happens if China makes contact first? In January, the world's largest single-dish radio telescope was declared fully operational in China. Beijing's steadfast commitment to improving the nation's position as a leader in the basic sciences can be gleaned from the fact that the construction of the 500-meter aperture spherical telescope was completed in 5 years, a remarkable achievement for a project and its technical complexity. The rushing of such a complex project has raised a few eyebrows in the West. It was set up to detect fast radio bursts that are being reported by American, Australian, and Russian monitoring stations. No one knows what these bursts mean, who is sending them, or why, but China are eager to be part of the process in uncovering such universal mysteries, and this has fast-tracked their understanding and indeed development of such technically advanced things like this new monitoring station. Bursts of extremely powerful radio waves from deep space of varying durations, whose origins remains a mystery, have been occurring for decades now. The most significant coming most recently, and the most dramatic, was in the form of the WOW signal. It is clear that the billions being spent to trace these radio waves is highly significant for humanity, as this may or may not be intelligent in origin. The giant telescope is working in coordination with SETI to help discover remnants and echoes of possible civilization in the universe that may be related to the human condition, and this has prompted a truly audacious plan by the American government to establish an even bigger detection telescope on the moon. Funding is now in place for NASA and other organizations to collaborate an effort to put a telescope inside a crater on the dark side of the moon that will be an unbelievable 1 mile in circumference, monumental if possible, and if possible, off the charts in anything ever done, ever. The Lunar Crater Radio Telescope, the LCRT, would be able to measure wavelengths and frequencies that can't be detected from Earth, blowing China out of the water and working unobstructed by the ionosphere or the various other bits of radio noise surrounding our planet all the time and obstructing our understanding of the cosmic things. If the plan goes ahead, it'll be the largest telescope in existence, destined to not only reveal the wonders of the entire solar system, but to allow us to peer into the mystery surrounding the great void that is the universe, possibly answering the anomaly as to why we are stranded here on Earth with no cosmic neighbors that we have detected. An ultra-long wavelength radio telescope on the far side of the moon has tremendous advantages compared to Earth-based and Earth-orbiting telescopes. Such a telescope can observe the universe at wavelengths greater and superior than anything in existence today, which are reflected by the Earth's ionosphere and are hitherto largely unexplored by humans. The moon acts as a physical shield that isolates the lunar surface telescope from radio interference, noises from Earth-based sources, ionosphere, Earth-orbiting satellites, and sun's radio noise during the lunar night. The American government aimed to deploy a 1 mile diameter wire mesh using wall-climbing dual-axle robots in a 3 to 5 kilometer diameter lunar crater on the far side, with subtle depth-to-diameter ratio to form a spherical cap reflector. The idea is still in the concept stage, but proposals have been accepted, so now it's down to this being possible and not impossible. It is mind-blowing to think that it might be a reality within this decade, the 2020s. The Lunar Crater Radio Telescope will be the largest field aperture radio telescope in the solar system. The LCRT would enable tremendous scientific discoveries in the field of cosmology by observing the early universe in the 1050 wavelength band, 6 to 30 megahertz frequency band, which has not been explored by humans to date. These types of mobilizations are truly curious because it shows that our governments are forming plans to detect these things that are signaling to us, maybe constantly. We humans have been sending signals into the cosmos for over 100 years now. It seems someone or something is responding much to our misjudgment to not have the capabilities in place to properly receive detections ourselves from possible extraterrestrial intelligence somewhere out there in the greater unknown. But what do you guys think about this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.